Tu sais que si un jour tu dois parler en anglais et qu'il te manque un mot, tu peux utiliser genre I was like, tu sais, I was like.
Du coup, ça marche pas du tout dans les commentaires, ça.
Dans les commentaires, c'est avec les smileys peut-être.
Bah, faites le meilleur smiley de I was like alors. Yeah.
Hello. Bonjour, ça va?
Ça va et toi?
Très bien, très bien. Très bien, merci. Is that right?
Great, and you? Yeah.
Very well, thank you, brother.
Français, anglais?
English, because my French is terrible. I want to learn, though, so you can teach me.
Okay.
I know, like, je t'aime. Will you teach me a naughty word in French?
I will speak English.
Okay, fine, deal.
Just for you.
Thank you, bro. I appreciate that.
How are you, young blood?
I'm very well, man. Are you?
You know Sikol?
Yeah, we have met. A man, he's a legend, man. You're cool as fuck.
He's a true legend. Oh. Look at him. He's turning red.
Yeah, sick puppies.
We want to know everything about you, young blood.
Let's get started, man. Yeah. I love it.
So, how you start with music?
Music was always on in my house.
Yeah?
Do you know, I mean, we would, like, music was the thing we would argue over at Christmas dinner.
Oh, yeah?
Do you know what I'm saying? Like, I think, I grew up in a guitar shop.
Whoa.
My old man ran a guitar shop. So I literally would, after school, go to the guitar shop every day and work at the guitar shop.
It was my dream.
Oh, brother, it was mental. I was so lucky. I was like, I remember, there's literally a picture of me outside the hospital, about 6 hours old, in a car seat on my dad's counter with a Beatles ukulele. So I think it was
it was
always music, man. Do you know what I mean? I don't think I could have been an accountant.
Yeah. And you play guitar? So
I play guitar.
Since you were a kid?
Play guitar since I was a kid. Like the boys, because I would always, everyone who worked in the shop was like 18 and have a nose ring or like, and be cool. And I'd like walk in the shop, I'd be like, all right. And they'd be like, what's up, Dom? And I'd be like, I just want to be like you. You know what I mean? And they would like play the songs and teach me like Placebo, to teach me Oasis, to teach me The Clash, The Jam, The Beatles, The Stone Roses. You know what I mean? They'd teach me all this like rock and roll music. Then I found like hip hop myself. And I remember walking into the shop with the boys. I was like, thinking they won't know this record. I was like, all right, what's going on? I was like, have you heard of a band called the Beastie Boys?
Wow.
And then they were joking to me. They're like, no. And I was like, oh, because I thought I was really cool. I was like 11, found the Beastie Boys, played like Sabotage. Everyone in the shop was like being so nice because they were pretending not to know who the Beastie Boys were until the verse came in and everyone just went, okay, Stan. I was like, no. You know, I was like, but I grew up there, man. It was the best thing ever.
So for the hip hop part, you started with Beastie Boys?
Yeah, like Beastie Boys, Grandmaster Flash, like Run DMC.
Whoa.
Do you know what I mean? All
the
that
only
stuff.
One.
Yeah, like all that stuff, like NWA and then Dre and then M and all that stuff. Yeah. And then it was so weird to me because I'd grown up on the Arctic Monkeys and Oasis and T-Rex and The Clash and the Sex Pistols and all this kind of punk music. But I got the same energy, but it sounded completely different. So I remember finding hip hop music and going like, whoa, this is like mind bending.
Don't you think that like all those bands, the early Def Jam's bands, like Run DMC, LL Cool J, etc., they were the punk.
Exactly,
from
of
New
that
York,
yeah, of that area. That's what I'm saying. It was so cool, man, because the city was like in kind of like division. Like there was like the New York Dolls, and then there was Grandmaster Flash going on all at the same time. So there was two revolutions in themselves within hip hop and punk, but they stand for the same things.
Yeah,
that's why like when you like meet like when you speak to like rappers and stuff at shows, or you kind of like go into a hip hop session, and I'm a rock artist, we get on so well because it's just about losing your fucking shit. Do you know what I mean? All people care about is just like going mental and just like, just being like, fucking, nah.
You're a real rock and roller.
Always, man.
Yeah, always. If there's one song that made you want to make music.
Oh, bro, this is like the Holy Grail. I'll probably say Don't Look Back in Anger by Oasis. Just because it's like, no matter what, if you put that on, everyone just goes crazy for it. Yeah. If you're playing a gig and shit goes wrong, if you shit your pants on stage, you could save it by playing Don't Look Back in Anger. Do you know what I mean? If like you it's shit your pants and fell off the stage and everyone was like, oh no, he shit himself. If you play Don't Look Back in Anger, it'll all be all right.
Let's play that song.
Well, let's do it, man. Let's do it. Should we do it?
All right.
Live. All right, sick, man, sick, man.
One, two. Slip inside the eye of your mind. Don't you know you might find a better place to play? You said that you've never been, but all the things that you've seen slowly fade away. So I start a revolution from my bed. Said the brains I had went to my head. Step outside, summertime's in bloom. Stand up beside the fireplace and take that look from off your face. You ain't ever gonna burn my heart out. And so Sally can wait. She knows it's too late as we're walking on by. The soul slides away. Don't look back in anger, I heard you say.
She's in Paris, France, everybody.
Take me to the place where you go, where nobody knows if it's night or day. But please don't put your life in the hands of a rock and roll band. We'll throw it all away. I'm gonna start a revolution from my bed. Said the brains I had went to my head. Step outside, cause summertime's in bloom. Stand up beside the fireplace, take that look from off your face. Cause you ain't ever gonna burn my heart out. And so Sally can wait. She knows it's too late as she's walking on by. My soul slides away. But don't look back in anger. Don't look back in anger. I heard you say.
Thank you for playing that, brother.
Thank you, man.
That was sick.
Wow.
Bro, I've always wanted to sing that song my whole life.
Yeah?
I sang it to the TV and in the mirror, but never on, like, a show with cameras and that.
I think it was the rock and rollest version of that song we play in fanzine.
Oh, I love that. That's what that song's got to be, man. Do you know what I mean? I literally just got to be, like, guitar, you learn it. A minute ago, like properly. That's just like rock and roll. Do you know what I mean?
I feel like I was your Noel for.
So cute, man. No, if Noel grew a beard, that's sick. That's what he looked like.
You like Liam?
I like them both, man. Do you know what I mean? I think they were both very integral to kind of who I am.
To me, what you're doing is like it's the new generation. You, Machine Gun Kelly, etc. Because it's a crew. You're friends with those guys.
That's the thing about it, is man. I think rock and roll had such a big. It fell asleep for a long time because there was no scene. There was no comradeship. There was like all these like rock and roll stars trying to do it on their own. Like I'm gonna bring back rock music. And rock music don't fucking, like, a scene can't happen like that. You can't bring a scene back yourself. You got to have friends and you got to have comradeship and you got to have rivalries and you got to have fights and you got to have fucking cuddles and you got to have... That's just how a scene comes back. You know what I'm saying? And I think very much right now, like, guitar music's coming back thick and fast and that's cool.
Yeah, and I'm sure that you're the new generation of rock and roller. For our kids, you'll be the new Rolling Stone. And
whoa, that would be crazy.
That's the way but it is.
I think that's it, man. I think, as I say, like, people are always going to feel the same. That's just human nature, even though we're generations apart. And we need that kickback, man. We need that energy. Yeah. We need that fire in our bellies, man, that only, like, rock and roll or music in general can provide. Not rock and roll, the genre, but the way of life, what it means, freedom.
Exactly.
Being yourself.
When I saw, and I think it was a great moment for you, Dave Grohl opening for you at the MTV Award, it was like, wow.
Bro, I shit myself, man.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like, fuck me, bruv. Like, he was in Nirvana. Do you know what I mean? He was in Nirvana, then the Foo Fighters, and he's just one of the, like, if I could have a career like one person, it would be like that man. Because he gets it. He speaks to me in a way that's just so, like, in my head and in my face.
Wow. How you start to be a musician, like, a pro, from the guitar shop to record your first album?
It was fucking mad.
Yeah.
It was like, it was a long time. You know what I mean? I remember I started Youngblood because I wanted to do rock music and I wanted to say something. You know what I mean? I went down to London at 16.
Oh, yeah?
And then some labels tried, like got interested in me and they wanted me to go on The Voice. It looked like this.
Yeah.
And I was like, nah, fuck that, man. So, I mean, not anything wrong with that, but it just wasn't me. You know what I mean? Everyone wanted me to be very poppy and very, like, voicey and be like, flut your eyelashes and sing about love. Do you know what I mean? And I was very much more like, I don't fucking like what's going on right now. I don't like the way people treat me. I don't like the way people look at me. I don't like the way people treat sexuality and racism. And I don't like the way the world is right now. And I could feel there was a shift in my generation coming. Because in the past 10 years, there's been a massive shift in my generation's kind of vocal ability. Our generation's vocal.
Yeah.
I was like, I want to sing about that. And everyone was like, don't sing about that. So I was like, bollocks to the labels. At the beginning. And then I just went off and did my own thing and no one would write about us.
Yeah.
No one would fucking write about us. Wow. I wish someone would say we were shit. No one said anything. But then we came to the Netherlands, and then we came to Cologne, and then we came to Paris and played Supersonic in Paris.
Yeah,
right? And 50 kids turned up. And then someone heard about us in America, and then we went to America, got signed, and...
And it turns global.
I just can't explain. I don't even know. I was just posting on social media every day and then the numbers were getting bigger and bigger.
Yeah.
And then the show started selling out.
Yeah,
it's like mind-blowing. I'm like, what the fuck?
Is there one song who changed everything?
Parents, I think.
Yeah?
I think that kind of... It was so funny because it was so outrageous. Everyone was like, don't put that out. It's so much. Like, the lyrics are fucking well naughty. It's going to do nothing. No radio will play that. No one will play it. And I was just like, fuck that. Do you know what I mean? I was like, let's put this out. It's saying something that's going to connect people. And it did.
Yeah,
more.
I think this song is very, like, speak to everyone.
It's just real, man. Do you know what I mean? I was just like... I was in a studio and it came about me just fucking about. It came about me just writing. I was like, let's just write the most outrageous thing we can think of. Like, I went out to the guard, my daddy put a gun to my head and said, if you kiss a boy, I'm gonna shoot you dead. So I tied him with gaffer tape, locked him in a shed, then went out to the guard and fucked my best friend. I was like, that's cool. And everyone's like, all right, sick man, sick. And then I just did that and it was like, it went.
Let's play an outrageous version.
Let's do it. Let's play the most outrageous version of it. I love it.
Cool.
Let's do it, man. I was born in a messed up century. My favorite flavor sweets are raspberry amphetamines. I bought a carburetor age 16. Brush my teeth with bleach cause I ain't got time for cavities. My daddy put a gun to my head. Said if you kiss a boy I'm gonna shoot you dead. So I tied him up with gaffer tape, locked him in a shed. Then I went out to the garden and I fucked my best friend. Cause my hey hopes are getting low. Cause these people are so old. The way they think about it all. If I tried, I would never know. My hey hopes are getting low. But I know I'll never be alone. It's alright, we'll survive. Cause parents ain't always right. I toast it in my bath. Watch my mom and dad laugh.
see a thousand balls go through the sun. They wish they never had it. Told me casual affection leads to sexual infection, but it's hard to get an erection when you're so used to rejection. Yeah, the teacher fought the preacher, then he had to leave her. Had to wash away the sins of a male cheerleader. Hi, nice to meet you. Got nothing to believe in, so let me know when my breathing stops. Kiss my hey, hope to get along, cause these people are so old. The way they think about it all, if I tried I would never know. High hopes are getting low, but I know I'll never be alone. It's alright, we'll survive, cause parents ain't always right.
Make some noise for Youngblood!
Yeah, man! Legend. So sick. I love what you did with the song as well.
Sequel made a great, great, great
dude,
track.
Dude, you're a legend, man. Like, drop in the comments if you want us to release that.
Man, on that track, everything that we speak was exactly here. There's some hip-hop, some rock, the real energy of punk. There's, I think, everything on that track. And I think that's why when I hear that track for the first time, I was like, wow. I think he opened a door which was never opened before.
Yeah, it feels sometimes, that way, doesn't it? It feels, yeah. It felt weird. I remember when we did it, I was like, I got a bit anxious because I was like, wow, that sounds like a bit mad.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I was like, is that shit or is it really good? Do you know what I mean? And then it turned out that people fuck with it, so it was cool.
Yeah, because the new rock and roll, in fact, the new style, because a lot of people say that the rock and roll is dead, but
and it's just different. That's the thing.
It's the proof that it's not.
That's the difference. It's like rock and roll ain't gonna sound what it sounded like last time. Like
which
in the same way. Well, like when sometimes if like older geezers, you know what I mean, who like rock and roll music, don't are like, oh, it's all been done before. I'm like, yeah, it has, but it's been done in a new way. In the same way that your dad, when you were listening to fucking Nirvana, was like, this sounds like shit.
Yeah,
or that
exactly.
His dad said when he was listening to the Stones that this sounds like shit. Or his dad, when he was listening to Chuck Berry, was like, this sounds like shit.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? It just develops and develops and develops and develops.
Yeah.
And we just borrow, but we reinvent, and that's cool as fuck.
You're listening to a lot of music, but what you're listening to now?
One of my favourite bands at the minute is a new rock and roll band. I mean, they're not that new, but they're like starting to get the kind of credit now. A band called Fontaines DC from Ireland. And I think this song is just cool as fuck.
Yeah, there's a little bit of Joy Division.
Absolutely, yeah. Like all that together with just this energy. It's got that kind of new wave energy in the fact that it just goes and goes and goes and goes and goes and goes and goes like that, like that, like that, like that, like that, like that, and you just get fucking mesmerised in it. Do you know what I mean? I think that's cool.
And you know those guys?
I drink at the same pub as them. We've DM'd a couple of times. We're going to link up for a pint, but obviously the coronavirus happened.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? So we couldn't get a pint of lager. But soon, boys.
Let's make a song.
If you don't fucking hate this cover.
I'm sure they will be glad.
Dude, I'm buzzing. I'm going to get the lyrics on my phone because he's Irish as fuck.
Okay.
Do you know what I'm saying? And it's like some of the words, I'm like, what the fuck does that mean?
All right.
Let's do it.
Life ain't always empty. 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 Don't get stuck in the past. Say your favourite things at mass. Tell your mother that you love her. And go out your way for others. Sit beneath a light that suits you and look forward to a brighter future. Life ain't always empty. Life ain't always empty. Life ain't always empty. Life ain't always empty. I said, life ain't always empty. Life ain't always empty. Life ain't always empty. Yeah. Sink as far down as you can be pulled up. Cause happiness really ain't all about love. Let your demeanor be your deep down self. And don't sacrifice your life for your health. And when you speak, speak sincere. And believe me friend, everyone will hear you. Cause life ain't always empty. 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 Life ain't always empty.
Yeah, man! Whoa! That was Hard Cabbage. Yeah, that was sick. I love that band. I hope they like that. That sounds cool. But that's what I was saying, brother. It's like, that felt like parents to me. Took a song like that and then put 808s underneath it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean.
That's so cool.
It's one of the greatest fanzine show that we made with you.
Yeah!
So now it's your show.
My show?
Yeah, we're doing exactly what you want.
Cool. Right, we all get naked. Can we play Mars?
Yeah.
My last song, man. Yeah. Can we do that?
We love that.
Dude, I'd love to do that, man. Yeah. That'd be so sick.
All right.
This is about a young trans girl I met in Maryland, in America, on tour. I can't remember what her face looked like, but I remember that she had green lipstick and a green matching duffel coat, and we were stood on wood chippings. I don't know why I remember that, like, so weird, but but she told me this story that she was having such an hard time with her parents because she was and always, in fact, had been a girl. And her parents just couldn't understand that. They thought, you know what I mean, she was their son and she wasn't. She was their daughter. And she said to me, she says, all I could think about was getting my parents to a Youngblood show. Not to see me or not to, like, anything to do with me, but to see the kind of the community is around it. And, like, I think kind of a representation of our generation, you know what I mean? And they came and they saw the people like her, the sort of passion, the sort of defiance to be like anything other than what we are. And they accept her as their daughter because they got it. This is what Youngblood's about. Do you know what I'm saying? It's like, it's so sick, and we always talk about like rock and roll and all that shit. But I got into music because I felt like I was an alien, and I want people, no matter what you're into, no matter what you like, no matter what you feel, no matter what you represent, you are welcome here. Do you know what I'm saying? Because it's a conversation. This community is a fucking conversation. And I want people to feel good. You know what I mean? That's what it's about.
Let's applaud that. Okay, let's play that song.
Let's do it. You ready? Ready to rock and roll?
She was only 17. Had the saddest pair of eyes that you ever seen. Wore them lips in a coat that was matching green. But she can't be herself when she's somebody else. In her mind she would take her mother's wedding ring. But school got pretty tough when it'd see it gleam. So she hid herself under the mezzanine, reenacting scenes, yeah. She dreamed she'd go to California, that everyone would adore her. And all her mates would call her till four in the morning. Is there any life on Mars? Is there any life on Mars? Is there any life on Mars? Yeah, yeah. Every morning she will wake up with another plan. Yet her mom and dad, they couldn't understand why she couldn't turn it off, become a better man. All this therapy so weighed gently at the side of her mind that she never had. Yeah, the story told too many times, it makes me sad. Better off and made a fortune out of autograph. Give her money by the card. She dreamed she'd go to California, there everyone would adore her. And all her mates would call her till far in the morning. Is there any life on Mars? Is there any life on Mars? Is there any life on Mars? Yeah, yeah. Is there any life on Mars? Is there any life on Mars? Any life on Mars? Yeah, yeah. Do you feel like you're irrelevant? Do you feel like you're irrelevant? Do you feel like you're just scared? Is there any life on Mars? Is there any life on Mars?
Thank you, Youngblood.
Ah, I love that song, man. It nearly makes me cry. I'm like,
thank you, man.
Brother, thank you so much, man. I loved every minute of this. This is so cool.
Every show, we finish the show with a little dance.
I'm fucking down, man.
You ready for that?
Yeah. I'll do your dance, yeah.
You have to learn to us a step.
A dance. Fucking hell, all right. All right, cool. Come on, then. You want to go?
Oh! Oh!
Whoa, fucking hell, I'm frightened to death. Yo, hello. Fuck me, that's frightened me to fucking
death. It's a robot.
Nice to meet you, robot man. Yeah. That fucking frightened me to death. I shit myself. I'm glad no one told me about that, you bastards.
Hard, all right, Northern Salt of Tram, I'm down.
Fucking right, yes.
Oh. I can't do that, I'll split my pants.
I love it, man. Thank you for having me. That's so sick.
Thank you, man.
Oh, man, I appreciate you. Thank you so much.